Now we're going to take a look at adding and subtracting radical expressions. Remember, radical just means things in a root. Adding and subtracting them really isn't that bad-ish. Adding and subtracting themselves isn't bad. What's annoying is simplifying them and then adding them together. So we'll do a little bit of both. Now, for adding and subtracting rational expressions, just remember, if I have 3x plus 2x, what do I get? Hopefully you've got this down by now. If you're looking at this, hopefully you've got this down by now. 3x plus 2x is 5x, right? Not a bad. All right. Well, by the same token, 3 square root of x plus 2 square root of x is also 5 square root of x. Similarly, 3 square root of x, you know, whatever, 5xyz plus 3, plus, I'm trying to be consistent, 2 square root of 5xyz. 3 of the whole point is 3 of blah plus 2 of blah is 5 of blah. 3 of blah plus 2 of blah is 5 of blah. So 3 of blah plus 2 of blah is still 5 of blah. Doesn't matter what the blah is, if I've got 2 of them and 3 more of them, I got 5 of them. 5 of them. Alright. 3 blah plus 2 blah is 5 blah. Similarly, you know, 7x minus 3x is 4x, right? So by the same expression, there's the same logic, you know, 7 cubed root of x squared y minus 3 cubed root of x squared y, 7 blah minus 3 blah, as long as the blahs are the same, is 4 blah. 7 blah minus 3 blah is 4 blah. Okay? So that's kind of where we're going with this now. You're like, oh, I can do this for, like, ages. A couple of things you want to watch for that they'll try to do to trick you sometimes. If you might say, well, let's go 7 square root of x plus 3 cubed root of x. Okay? This... done. There's nothing you can do to this. It would be like saying 7x plus 3y, right? You can't do anything with that. You're done. If the roots are different, like that's a square root and that's a cube root, you're just kind of finished. Similarly, if you had like a cube root of x plus a cube root of x squared, you're still done. If it's not exactly the same thing, and you can't manipulate it to make it the same thing, you're just done. If it's not the same thing, you have to finish. Again, for the same reason that you can't do anything with this. The x and the y aren't the same, so you're just kind of stuck with it. Okay? So, it's very, actually, pretty unlikely you're going to get problems as straightforward as the ones we just did. It's more likely that you're going to get problems that you have to simplify and then add together. So it's more likely you'll get something like you know, the square root of 20 plus 2 square root of 45. Okay. So in a problem like this, you're going to have to use what we've learned previously about simplifying radical expressions to simplify these and then add them together. So the 20 goes into 4 and 5. The 4 and 45 goes into... turns into a 9 and a 5. Remember doing this? So that's 2 square root of 5, 3 square root of 5. And if this is complete, if you have absolutely no idea what I'm doing, this whole lesson is going to be a complete waste of your time. You need to go back and you need to look at how to simplify radical expressions, both for variables and for numbers. So you need to be good at that before you do this, or I hate to say it, there's just no point, because you have, they build on each other. So 2 root 5 plus 6 root 5. Now I've got something where I have 2 of something, 2 blah plus 5 plus 6 blah. So 2 blah plus 6 blah is 8 blah. So 2 blah plus 6 blah is 8 blah. Okay? So since there's really not a whole lot more to this than just getting some experience. There's not a whole lot of theory. It's just the simplification, I think, usually is what drives people crazy. I'm just going to give you some problems to work, and then we'll come back and do them together. All right? So take a look here at these problems. Try to simplify them. I gave you three just to give you more practice. It's just the same. Don't let that, you know, this you should be able to do, right? 7 plus 9 is 16, you know. 4 plus 3 plus 9 is 16. So it's the same thing. I just gave you three of them to give you some practice. So pause the video, try to write these out, and then come back and see if you got them right. So now, so you've done that, let's work the first one. Okay. So again, I'm just going to break these out a piece at a time. So that's going to be 9 times 3 times the square root of x. It's going to be, right? Did I do that right? Yeah. Okay. I feel like I'm skipping too many steps already. What a silly problem. But 8 has a square in it as well, so it must be 36 times 2. Okay. I hate to do this to you, but I'm kind of crazy sometimes. So, square root of 3, square root of x, 3 square root of x, 6 square root of a 2, square root of a 2, square root of x. Alright, so that's 3 root 3x minus 6 root x plus 6 root 2x. Now, actually, I kind of threw a tricky one at you right at the beginning, not to shatter your confidence. I kind of didn't mean to do that. I meant to put this one second, but, you know, live and learn. You can't add these together, and you need to resist the urge to do so. This is a 3x. This is an x. This is a 2x. So you can think about this as like x, y, z, a, b, c. They're not the same thing. So that means we can't add them together. We just have to leave. What happened? We have to leave these as they are. Okay, but that's okay because it still looks better. Still kind of, sort of. Shut up. It looks better, I swear. Okay. I should refrain from telling people I don't know to shut up. I don't mean it. Let's try this one. 54. My cube roots are 8, 27. So that's 2 cubed, 3 cubed. And I can see the 27 is going to work. So 27 times 2. This is 8 times 2. And this guy's fine. He's just chilling. So cube root of 27 is 3. And this guy's left over. This is 2. And this guy's left over. And then there's this guy. And now this is looking a little better. 3 cube root of 2 minus 10 cube root of 2 plus yet another cube root of 2. So, taking a look at this, I can recognize, okay, the units, I guess, are the same for all of these. So I have 3 minus 10 plus, remember what this is here? Plus? Remember there's like a secret 1? Plus 1. 3 minus 10 plus 1 would be minus 6 cube root of 2. Minus 6 cube root of 2. Now if that plus 1 is bothering you, think about this. If I had 3x minus 10x minus x, or plus x, which is kind of the same thing, you might say minus x. You probably wouldn't hesitate to do this, okay? So think about whatever gets you through this. That's a little bit. Think about whatever gets you through that to get to this here that we're doing, okay? One more. It's good for you. So we'll separate these out. into, let's see, 48 is 8 times 6, cube root of y to the 4th, cube root of 6, cube root of y to the 4th, okay, cube root of 8 is 2, that, ooh, and I can do this one, it's a terrible 4, 4 divided by 3 is 1 remainder 1. 4 divided by 3 is 1 remainder 1. So 1 remainder 1. This guy is just a mess. 1 remainder 1. So I've got those can go together. These guys can go together. That guy can be out front. And these guys can go together. So again, you've got 2y plus y of blah. So 2y plus y is 3y with blah. So 3y blahs. And that's your answer. Wasn't that fun? So again, just the more of these you do, the better you're going to get at it. And I think really for success in these problems, you have to have success in going from this step. It's usually not this step that's the problem. It's usually the very, very first one. So again, if you're kind of weak on the simplifying the radical expressions, get that solid first before you try too many of these problems to avoid yourself some significant headaches going on.